over taking some notes. Taking some notes on their reaction patterns, their behavior patterns. Very interesting. Working on our PhD in behavioral studies and human culture and human growth. And this is very interesting. Should be here a while. We don't want to bother them. So we're kind of under camouflage here. Yeah. Well, what is it that we hope to gain in this, in the study? What exactly are we studying human culture for? What exactly are we studying human culture for? Is the question, right? Now, I would suggest that it's much ado about nothing. It's a complete waste of time, actually. And call off the studies. Call off the studies. Seriously. I am not here to be studied. I am not here to study somebody else. Why study nothing? Why study a dream? Why study hallucination? We are here to wake up from our coma. We are from here to wake up from our dream. And the problem we have is the continuity problem. There's nothing to study, actually. The only purpose we're here is to get right information. We're not supposed to be studying each other in terms of our behavior, okay? We are not. Our behavior is entirely derived from the from not waking up. We already know what our problem is in terms of how this came about. So we need to be informed about what our problem is, not study behavior of reactions, human reactions, behavioralism, human reactions. That is the path of delay. That is the path of irresponsibility, actually. Do not look at people as reaction objects, as objects of study. We've been turned in here to objects of study, as if people are doing a field study on us, right? This is so wrong. It's off the charts wrong, okay? Extreme ignorance is driving this, and we cannot put up with this. Our sole responsibility is to come out of this coma. And how we do that with the help of the Holy Spirit. And this is not some aboriginal voodoo witch doctor, sympathetic magic stuff. All that stuff, we don't need to study it. We really don't need to study anything here in this world. World is not important in terms of location, objects, and how objects interact with one another. Because the remedy for waking up from this dream of projection, perception, personality, is to see the vision of oneness. All right, that is the whole goal, the whole purpose. And that has nothing to do with the interaction of objects. It is object interaction transcendent. So what we need to do is to de-emphasize behavioral studies. Okay, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter at all. De-emphasize all behavioral studies. De-emphasize your commenting and noticing of people's reactions and emotions and peculiarities and all this. All that stuff is wrong emphasis. Wrong emphasis. Shift to the realm of ideas, to the realm of clarification, and put your emphasis there. Find out how, what the original projection was, why we did it, how that led to a continual cascade, a domino effect of projection following projection following projection. Projection begets projection. How all of that ended up producing this sensory perception, and how sensory perception inherently amplifies the belief in projection and brings about a state called judgment. And the state of called judgment is what we call the personality. Now the personality, again, amplifies judgment. and how this produces this extreme forgetfulness of reality. It produces an extremely deep coma of forgetfulness. And how we have to turn that around, and we turn that around through the help of the Holy Spirit, which is God's creation, a blessing upon spirit, to solve this continuity issue that we have of fear of setting all this projection down instantly, forever. We're too afraid to do that, so the Holy Spirit's able to work with our projections, with our perception, with our personality, but turning it all towards saying we have just one problem. We don't have multiple problems. See, if we only have one problem, which is true, we only have a continuity problem, then why do we need to be studying one another? Why do we need to be studying one another? We already know what our problem. Everyone has the exact same problem. This is my perspective. Everyone has the exact same problem. So it doesn't matter to me how people act or what they say or anything like that. It doesn't. I see people, I just don't pay any attention as to their personality. Try not to, you know, and don't comment on personalities. But the world is addicted to personalities. And we're studying personalities. That is a complete waste of time, to study personalities. Say, I have only one problem. Everyone has the exact same problem, the continuity problem. And since everyone has the exact same problem, the solution to this problem applies to everybody equally. Applies to everyone equally. There's only one problem and one solution to it. So what is there to study? There's nothing to study. There is nothing to study. That's why I was so adamant against studying. I never studied in school. I said, this is all complete waste of time. Complete waste of time. Utter misdirection. There's nothing to study except the continuity issue and the resolution of that continuity issue, which is already set by God for us, is the vision of oneness. So it's not up to us to set what our options are. The options are set for us. It's only delay that we're engaged in. We either stay in our coma or we wake up from the coma. And the way to wake up is already set, is the vision of oneness. And within the vision of oneness, there is no behavioral focus at all. There's no importance on behavioral issues. What you're seeing is that everyone is equally abiding in this perfect plenum of perfectly smoothed out, seamless everywhereness. That there's this, is God, abidance in everything's equally abiding in that. And you have this feeling of this, of the just, there's just one identifying factor of everything. Everything shares in this one identifying factor. And it's this total kinship with everything. We feel this total oneness with everything. That we all share exactly the same intrinsic existential condition. Or what would they say? Ontological characteristic of this abidance, equal abidance in the smoothed out everywhereness. So behavior has nothing to do with that, does it? Absolutely nothing to do with that. It doesn't matter what the dance is. The dance is always taking place within this everywhereness. And this is what we need to realize. Because we've been thinking that we've been focusing on the dance and not seeing where this dance is taking place. So we've been focusing on the quirks and the eccentricities and differences of personalities and things, where we should be seeing the complete sameness of everything in terms of its actual being. So again, we're up against this Frankenstein monster projection that we have made, and how that has permeated our academic schooling and academic system and the whole cult of the personality on this planet, and how everybody, this attitude of we're studying other people, especially as you get up into academics more and more and more, there's this idea that somehow to be smart, you're supposed to study behavior. Like we get a cat or a dog and we try to figure out how to train them properly and what their behavior is and what the reactions are and you know, stimulus response research, and which leads to, it permeates our culture and society to a monstrous extent. All of that is a complete waste of time. Complete waste of time. You could say the world is utterly wasting its time. Every day in this world, I look at the world, I see the world is just a complete waste of time. Nothing's happening. Nothing's happening here. And that's a crying shame. You know, it's a burden. So, the everywhereness is not reacting. It doesn't have any reaction characteristics. It's completely smoothed out sameness. Untouched by anything that seems to be that's dancing around. All the decorations that are dancing around. Untouched by it. Unchanged by it entirely. So there's nothing to study about reality. Reality is not something to study. It's perfect freedom from study. And those who hear, who realize this, they're not here to be studied. They're not here to be studied. You can notice the smoothed outness. You notice that for sure. But they're not objects of study. What they turn you to is practice. You have to practice. Don't make people and things into objects of study. That's the wrong direction to go in. Rather make them motivation, turn them in everything into motivation to practice. And what practice does is it reorients our conceptual expectations, our whole expectation framework towards vision of oneness. We have to do that. We have to do that. That's our part of resolving the continuity issue. We have a small role to play. And we have to reorient our expectations towards experiencing the vision of oneness and abiding in it. So if you go see someone who is awakened from their coma, what they're going to do is say, okay, here's how you start practicing. Get practicing. Don't be turning me into an object of study, or you're not here on an anthropological mission. You know, we may come to the guru and with our mask on, you know, we're saying, I've come across a guru, I've come across a rare animal here. And I've got to stay undercover and see, check the situation out and see it and figure out what makes them tick. Why are they laughing when they laugh? Why are they laughing this way? Why are they making those gestures? How are they interacting with others? What is the pattern? What is their personality pattern? And we go to it like that. Now take that off. That has nothing to do with it. Anyone you go to, you should only go if they're motivating your practice. There is no other reason. Because each one of us has to come out of our coma, and we have to turn our conceptual framework of expectations around. Turn our expectations towards a vision of oneness, which takes practice, which takes study, contemplation, but most of all, declarations, affirmations, practice, meditational practices, different ways of reorienting yourself, reorienting your expectations of experiencing, reorienting your expectations. The guru doesn't want to be studied. They're not interested in being studied. They're interested in you reorienting your expectations through practice so that you can awaken from your coma through the vision of oneness. Everyone who's awakened knows the vision of oneness. That is what everyone has to experience and has to abide in. So the world is not doing us any favors by its misemphasis. And it's really a terrifying place in terms of this relentless misdirection. So what we try to do every day is we try and push our practicing further, further, further. Which means not studying the behavioral characteristics, the existential activities of Homo sapiens, or of animal kingdom, or insect kingdom, all the stuff that we're frantically studying. Drop the study. It's a waste of time. It makes absolutely no difference. Everything as it is now. Is in the nowness of the oneness of everywhereness. Already everything as it is. There's nothing to study. The condition that we need to see is already present. Without the slightest bit of study on anyone's part. In fact, it's always present. So what needs to be studied exactly? No necessity to study anything. No reason to take notes on anything. What are we taking notes on? Part of the reason why we recoil from the vision of oneness and looking back at that is we feel like we're so amazed, like, oh my gosh, there's nothing I need to do. And we kind of feel like, well, we need to do something. I mean, we got to study something. There's nothing to study there. Nothing to study there. It's the end of academia. It's the end of academia. There's nothing to seek. It's the end of our seeking. This plant is the end of my seeking. This plant, as it is the end of my seeking. This day as it is, is the end of my seeking. This tree, as it is the end of my seeking. This wall, as it is the end of my seeking. Those birds as they are, just as they are, is the end of my seeking. This air, as it is the end of my seeking. This sky, as it is the end of my seeking. This planet, as it is the end of my seeking. My seeking comes to an end with this sky, as it is. This universe, as it is the end of my seeking. This stone, as it is, is the end of my seeking. That wall, as it is the end of my seeking. So, as you're going about your day, as you're walking, as you're driving, as you're sitting, as you're lying, resting, lying down, whatever, this, say, everything around you, your surroundings, and anything you can imagine, this as it is the end of my seeking. So as you're walking along, this tree is the end of my seeking. Those oranges, that orange is the end of my, as it is the end of my seeking. It's the end of all seeking. This flower, as it is the end of all seeking. This moment, as it is the end of all seeking, all my seeking. That house, as it is the end of all my seeking. The end of all seeking. You can say it either way, whatever, you can variate a little bit. So what happens in this world is we go about mindlessly, which is really, this planet is a cult. You get brainwashed to the point where you spend your time mindlessly. So you go to school, you ride your bike, you walk to school, you drive your car to work, you go on a vacation, you take a walk in the evening, whatever you're doing, as you spend the hours of your day, you're doing it mindlessly. You're not practicing. You're not practicing. That's what happens. That's how I've lived my life. It's like you just can't, sort of blank, like a blank mind. I don't know what anything's for. I don't know what anything is for. I just kind of went around and said, what is this for? I don't know what this is for. I don't know what this is for. I don't know what anything really is for. But if you start practicing, then you give it the only meaning that it has for you, really. And say, this tree, as it is totally the end of all my seeking. You see, you just used your time in the right way then. This walkway that I'm walking along, just as it is the end of all my seeking. This stone wall, just as it is, this stone wall as it is the end of all my seeking. So you see, you're not studying the tree or the wall or the sky or anything. You are giving it the only meaning that it has for you. And you're saying, this as it is is the end of all my seeking. Because what is the end of all my seeking? The vision of oneness. All things, just one. One shared identification factor. All having the exact same identifying characteristic of perfect abidance in everywhereness of God, pure spaciousness of God. So most of us spend our entire lives completely mindlessly, and we never even get started. But here we have the opportunity to get started. It rarely do we get this push of how to be truly mindful, because the push of this world is the pressure of this world is so extreme. We can go through our whole lives mindlessly. That is a wasted life. This pebble, you're walking along a trail. That pebble, as it is the end of all seeking. This dirt, as it is the end of all seeking. And try to allow sort of a feeling of relief to come to you, like a profoundness. If you do it right, you'll feel sort of like a sort of a almost stunned profoundness, relief, kind of like, wow. That weed, as it is the end of all my seeking. So we're preparing ourselves for seeing that everything as it is, there's no more need to seek at all. Without doing anything, we are aware of the defining characteristic of everything. That bird that just flew in, that bird as it is the end of all seeking. Now, also what's important is don't intellectualize it. As soon as you try to think about it, intellectualize it, try to understand it from the level of personality, you feel awkward. It immediately feels awkward. So you have to decide whether you're going to try to study things or give it the meaning that it has for you. So what we're doing is we're simply giving it the only meaning, real meaning, that it can possibly have for us. Which is saying everything has the exact same identifying, defining characteristic. I know the definition of all things. See, the vision of oneness reveals the definition of everything. And it's actually just one definition of everything. This tree as it is the one definition of everything. There's another practice. This street, I'm walking down the street, this street as it is the one definition of everything. Or this street as it is the one definition. This street as it is the oneness. This street as it is the one definition of everything. This fence I'm walking by, as it is the one definition of everything. This house that I'm walking by, that house over there, that house, as it is the one definition of everything. That telephone pole, as it is, shares in the one definition of everything. Or is the one definition of everything. So the personality will encroach and your practice will suddenly feel awkward. Okay, so then just back off a little bit. Don't force it. This is what happens. You do the practice for a little while and it's so effective, the personality starts, you start getting nervous, like, oh my gosh, this is working. And then you kind of say, well, what do you mean by that? Remember, we're giving it the definition that it has for us. And we taking on faith that we know that there's only one definition for everything. Everything has the exact same definition. This telephone pole has the one definition. Is the one definition. This road spaciousness is the one definition. Is the one. This telephone pole spaciousness is the one. This house spaciousness as it is the one. This lawn spaciousness, as it is the one. Shorthand. So we're giving it the meaning it has. And that is agreeing with God that has the one definition of pure spaciousness. Abiding in pure spaciousness, abiding in pure spaciousness. That car, as it is the one definition. Share seems like a part, you know, like this is giving a part to it. It's not like that. It's not quite like that. So we're walking down a street. See, this street, as it is totally into it. Is totally into it. Now we understand what we mean by that. This tree as it is totally in it. Is totally in it. Into it. Totally in it. This tree as it is in total abidance. This street as it is in total abidance. This sky as it is in total abidance. That chimney as it is in total abidance. Everything I see is in total abidance. This air that I breathe is in total abidance. That puddle is in total abidance. My surroundings are in total abidance. That mountain over there is in total abidance. This world as it is in total abidance. That creek, as it is in total abidance. Very simple and easy, right? And yet, almost everyone in this world, with rare exception, goes through their entire life never doing this. That tire, as it is in total abidance. Now you need to kind of shift because the personality keeps chasing after you and saying, no, wait a minute, like that. And tries to engage you in explanations like, explain, what do you mean in total abidance? What do you, you know, drop it then. If the personality is trying to get you, engage you with it, drop it, refocus, and then do some other practice. You have to stay one step ahead of the personality as it's desperately struggling to keep its authority over you. You don't want it to become merely rote practice. That doesn't do much of anything. So you really need to keep the Holy Spirit, keep following its lead as to how to practice. And use every expedient you can to keep generating practice in your day. And not fall into the just mechanical rote repetition like a parrot. And you know, parrot, you could teach a parrot to say, this is this. Parrot doesn't know what it's saying, this is this. But we do. See, this is totally this. This tree is totally this tree. This tree as it is totally this tree. Don't look for a personality explanation of it. Refuse to engage in that. Just feel, you can feel the traction that this has, how the personality is stunned and muted. Just continue to stun and mute the personality that way, which again, the personality actually is the complex that arises from perception, sensory perception. And sensory perception is the complex that arises from projection. And projection is what is the complex that arises when spirit wants to try and become prime creator. But all of this is merely fantasy. But because we're addicted to fantasy, we need a continuity resolution which reminds us of reality still within the realm of least plausible fantasy, thingness. This tree is it. This tree is totally it. There's another way. This tree is totally it. You're walking along, you see a flower. This flower is totally it. That bug is totally it. That light, that neon light there is totally it. This door is totally it. This door is totally it. These address, brass address numbers are totally it. That cloud is totally it. This world is totally it. This universe is totally it. This hand is totally it. This gutter is totally it. See how you can do that with this conviction that knocks the personality out. That's what you're looking for. Not with conviction is different than emotion. We're not being emotional. I'm still emotionally very calm and neutral. But there's an intensity of conviction, of certitude that we're applying here. You can tell because my breath is still entirely even and calm. So there's no emotion being applied here, really. That palm tree is totally it. That sky is totally it. This dirt is totally it. This quietness is totally it. You don't want to overdo it. Make that burst. If you overdo it, you start getting a little scared, and then you'll turn to the personality, and the personality will start asking questions, and then the whole thing feels awkward. So what I'm doing is I'm letting it cool down, the whole thing cool down, and then we'll shift over to some other form of practice. This day is the endless day. This valley is the endless valley. That grove of trees is the endless grove of trees. That crosswalk is the endless crosswalk. That plant is the endless plant. That plant is the endless plant. That flower is the endless flower. That board is the endless board. That roof is the endless roof. That roof is the endless roof. So we're not trying to give it sensory qualities, right? We're giving it spiritual qualities. In practicing, we always give it a spiritual quality, which is a form of perception. It's a spiritual form of perception. Endlessness, isness, oneness. When we don't see the spiritual quality of everything, we're seeing a blankness. And we try to fill up that blankness with food and, you know, feeding the personality. And now we'll do the chain thing. You can get a new chain thing. That concrete is the endless sky. That sky is that endless tree. That tree is this endless wall. This wall is that endless road. This mailbox is the endless sidewalk. Something like that. This sidewalk is the endless fence. This fence is the endless shrub. This shrub is the endless world. This world is this endless dust particle. This endless dust particle is this endless mountain. This endless mountain is this endless forest. This endless forest is this endless paperclip. This endless paperclip is this endless fountain. This endless fountain is this endless car. This endless car is this endless person. This endless person is this endless dirt. So isness, endlessness. Spiritual qualities. And this chain is your doing this continuum, the seamless continuum, practicing, getting used to that it's everywhereness. This street is the everywhereness of this building, which is the everywhereness of that tree, which is the everywhereness of that sky, which is the everywhereness of this space, which is the everywhereness of that cloud, this water faucet, which is the everywhereness of this moss, which is the everywhereness of this cat, which is the everywhereness of these stones, which is the everywhereness of that shrub, which is the everywhereness of this flower, which is the everywhereness of that gate, which is the everywhereness of that tubing, which is the everywhereness of that chimney, which is the everywhereness of that clock, which is the everywhereness of today, which is the everywhereness of everywhere, which is the everywhereness of now, which is totally now. And truth is always true, and lies can never be true. All lies are forever lies. Now is totally now. Now is totally now. Now is totally now. And then you cool down a little bit. You cool down a little bit because you're stunned. A little bit stunned. This is a completely different way of organizing your perception, right? Your expectations. It's a completely different way of looking at your experiential expectations of what you're going to be experiencing, perceiving. So we're you know, a little bit stunned. And again, you can include a person, etc., but don't get caught up in personalities, people. Keep moving your attention around, all here, far away, close up, medium distance, small, large, and, you know, medium size. Just keep practicing shifting all those things. Don't fixate on anything. Don't get fixated on anything. It's very important. Don't get fixated. Don't let your attention fixate on anything when you're practicing. Don't get fixated and stopped on something. Because then the personality, you're thinking, you're not practicing. You're not giving it the meaning, the only meaning that it has for you. You got to use your will. You will that this is so. You're practicing that. And you're practicing your will is touching everything. You're blessing the entire world, the entire universe. This plant blesses the entire universe. This stone blesses the entire universe. That kind of thing. This flower blesses the entire universe. This flower is a universal blessing. This flower is the universal blessing. This tree is the universal blessing. This sky is the universal blessing. This spaciousness here, this spaciousness is the universal blessing. This seed floating in the air, this seed is the universal blessing. That leaf, that rustling leaf is the universal blessing. That tree trunk is the universal blessing. That wall is the universal blessing. That rooftop is the universal blessing. That meadow is the universal blessing. That cow is the universal blessing. This pebble is the universal blessing. That concrete is the universal blessing. That steel is the universal blessing. That downspout is the universal blessing. That pot is the universal blessing. This day is the universal blessing. This flower is the universal blessing of this shrub, which is the universal blessing of this walkway, which is the universal blessing of this thermometer, which is a universal blessing of this light, which is the universal blessing of this plant, which is the universal blessing of this table, which is the universal blessing of this couch, which is the universal blessing of that wire, which is the universal blessing of these stones, which is the universal blessing of this palm tree, which is the universal blessing of that bird, which is the universal blessing of that tree, which is the universal blessing of this day, which is the universal blessing of this world, which is the universal blessing of this shoe, which is the universal blessing of that twig, which is the universal blessing of that paver stone, which is the universal blessing of that branch, which is the universal blessing of this camera, which is the universal blessing of that tire, which is the universal blessing of that car, which is the universal blessing of that road, which is the universal blessing of this city, which is the universal blessing of this planet, which is the universal blessing of this universe, which is the universal blessing of right now, which is right now, which is the universal blessing of now. Truth is true. Truth is always true. Lies are always lies. All lies are forever lies. All lies are forever lies. Truth is true. Truth is totally true right now. Truth is totally true right now. And then you give a little cool down. Here they are again, the clowns, the clown crows, the squadron is flying over us as we speak. Oh my gosh. Trying to disrupt our practice, no doubt. And it is disruptive, actually, if you focus on it at all. The thing we have to do is just completely ignore the personality. It doesn't matter. Continue with our practice. But that was enough to break the smoothness of it, wasn't it? Yeah. So I feel a little bit like I sort of lost track a little bit. So it's important to whatever is taking place around you. You mean you're the one who's giving meaning to everything. Not the crows are not giving meaning to your world at all. You're giving the meaning to the crows and to everything. That crow is the one meaning. This helicopter is the one meaning. This helicopter as it is the one meaning. That chime is the one meaning. This day is the one meaning. It's the only meaning there is. This helicopter is the only meaning there is. That crow is the only meaning there is. This breeze is the only meaning there is. This breeze as it is the only meaning there is. This walkway as it is the only meaning there is. This space as it is the only meaning there is. Those flowers as it is the only meaning there is. That hedge as it is the only meaning there is. That hedge as it is the only meaning there is. Now the personality will say, what do you mean by that? Time to back off. Don't reply to the personality. Go on to the next practice. Don't explain to the personality. This sacred tree is this sacred sky, is this sacred plane, is this sacred bird, is this sacred shrub, is this sacred tree, is this sacred plant, is this sacred planet, is this sacred river, is this sacred day, is this sacred dirt, is this sacred bottle, is this sacred sign, is this sacred road, is this sacred car, is this sacred foot, is this sacred house, is this sacred dog, is this sacred moment, is this sacred universe, is this sacred space. Truth is always true. Truth is always true. Truth is always true. And lies are never true. This day is the one day, one space. This planet is the one space. My surroundings, this is the one space. This tree is the one space. That leaf, that falling leaf is the one space. That closing door is the one space. That power saw is the one space. That little insect is the one space. That dust particle is the one space. That spider web is the one space. That light is the one space. This and now is the one space. This one space is the one space. This universe is the one space. This branch is the one space. This mat is the one space. This baseball is the one space. This lawn is the one space. This scene is the one space. This place is the one space. This space is the one space. This space is the one space. Truth is always true, and lies are forever lies. Now is now. Now is totally now. Now is totally now. So these are like wind sprints. What we're doing is we're staying ahead of the personality. This is what I'm finding out. It's very difficult to continue practice for a long time without the personality sort of like tugging you down, and it becomes more of just a exercise for the sake of exercise. You kind of lose the potency of it. Now, what's important in these exercises is, again, don't exclude anything, don't overemphasize anything. That's why it's not always, it's fine to be in a beautiful place, okay? But what can happen is you think that this place is it. Like you're standing like in Yosemite, Merced River, or a bridge over the Merced River or something. And you just look at the river and saying, ah, this is so peaceful, this is so nice. And your mind just kind of goes blank there. That's not what we're talking about here. The tranquility meditation is not what we're talking about. What we're talking about is preparing for the vision of oneness. Now, I can do this because I've had a couple good glimpses of the vision of oneness just recently. And so I kind of have a feel of what kind of exercises are going to help us move into that. If, let's say you're at the Merced River in Yosemite, and many people have been to Yosemite from all over the world. Very stunning place, right? But that's not the issue. What's important is to practice the same way we're practicing sitting here, you know, sitting in your room, and sitting out in some suburban, you know, house, an apartment, wherever. Sitting in a classroom, sitting in your office. Same practice. You might say, if you're saying the Merced River, you would say, This river is the sacredness of this sky, which is the sacredness of that cliff, which is the sacredness of that waterfall, which is the sacredness of this planet, which is the sacredness of this dragonfly, which is the sacredness of that stone, which is the sacredness of that campfire, which is the sacredness of this tree, which is the sacredness of that boat, which is the sacredness of this breath, which is the sacredness of that mountain, which is the sacredness of this space, which is the sacredness of this universe, which is the sacredness of that flower, which is the sacredness of that dirt, which is the sacredness of that smoke, which is the sacredness of that cabin, which is the sacredness of this board, which is the sacredness of this day, which is the sacredness of this moment, which is the sacredness of now. And now is totally now. Now is totally now. Truth is totally true, and all lies are forever lies. Truth is forever true. All truth is forever true, and all truth is forever now. All truth is totally forever now. See, the personality loves to fixate us on something beautiful. Say, oh yeah, I'm so, that's so beautiful, so beautiful. Your mind kind of goes blank. You don't want that. Because what we're going toward, the vision of oneness, is we're seeing, I can't say exactly what we're seeing because then the personality will start asking questions. But just trust me that there's no exclusions. Everything equally has the exact same identity, and therefore we say there's only one identity. Everything has exactly the same meaning, which we say there's one meaning. Everything has exactly the same location in regard to everywhereness. So sameness of everything, both manifest and unmanifest. That's what we're going towards. So if we're just fixating on this beautiful waterfall, and it's, oh, let me take a picture of this waterfall, and oh, it's such a beautiful waterfall. Look at that, it's sparkling in the sun, it's so beautiful. That's not practicing. That's not practicing. That's fixation. That's what the ego personality tries to do. It says, this location that I'm at is prime. I'm here at the right location. The other locations I'm judging is not as nice as this. This is what I'm really fixated on. That's what we want to get away from. We want to get away from that. Do not fixate on anything in your practicing. But be leisurely. You can be leisurely in your going from one thing to another, far, distant. Keep practicing the distant, the close, the small, the big, the medium, mixing it all up. Not like meticulously, like obsessive, compulsive, like I did something far away, the next thing has to be really close or anything. Don't know. Just spontaneously make sure you're not falling into any patterns. Keep breaking it up. So you know, then follow a pattern, like, okay, this pattern is the answer. There's no pattern in the vision of oneness. This tree is pattern free. This day is pattern free. This day is the pattern freeness of this universe, which is the pattern freeness of this planet, which is the pattern freeness of that star, which is the pattern freeness of this leaf, which is the pattern freeness of this hillside, which is the pattern freeness of this grass, which is the pattern freeness of that bird, which is the pattern freeness of this lawn, which is the pattern freeness of that squirrel, which is the pattern freeness of this walnut, which is the pattern freeness of this ocean, which is the pattern freeness of this river, which is the pattern freeness of this smog, which is the pattern freeness of this car, which is the pattern freeness of this flower, which is the pattern freeness of this bottle. So whatever it is, don't worry about trying to establish a pattern. It's the pattern freeness of this now, which is the pattern freeness of this now, which is the pattern freeness of this space, which is a location freeness of now, which is a location freeness of this shrub, patternless, locationless, patternless, okay? Which, and truth is totally true now. Truth is always true. Truth is always true. All lies are forever lies. All lies are forever lies. No lie can ever become true. All lies are forever lies. Truth is totally true now. And then you take a break. You wonder how those basketball players get in shape. By running wind sprints from, you know, baseline to baseline. Then they take a break, rest, they run another wind sprint. Take a rest, do another wind sprint. That's how you really get in shape. Jogging, like you go out and jog, I'm going to jog for 50 minutes. Well, that's fine. But try doing, you know, 20 wind sprints. That is going to get you in shape. And we need to be in shape, spiritual shape right now. We need to be in great spiritual shape. I'm neglecting my physical conditioning, as I always do, because it is more important to be in great spiritual shape right now, condition. Now, don't turn to the personality for ideas. Do not. You think, oh, I need some idea to practice. Oh, what do you think the personality? Then you start struggling. Immediately you start struggling. Don't try to please the personality. Personality will suggest something that pleases it. Don't do it. If you need to, just be quiet and just rest. Catch your breath. And turn to the vision of oneness. The continuity problem is the only problem I have. The vision, only the vision of oneness has value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. Therefore, this tree is the location freeness of this sky. Is the location freeness of this concrete, is the location freeness of this wall, is the location freeness of this house, is the location freeness of this stone, is the location freeness of this dirt, is the location freeness of that roof, is the location freeness of those shrubs, is the location freeness of that pot, is the location freeness of that orange, is the location freeness of that car, is the location freeness of this planet, is the location freeness of this ladder, is the location freeness of this table, is the location freeness of that hedge board, is the location freeness of that wire, is the location freeness of that tree, is the location freeness of that flower, is the location freeness of this light, is the location freeness of this bark, is the location freeness of that dog, is the location freeness of those people, is the location freeness of that fountain, is the location freeness of this space, is the location freeness of right now, is the location of freeness of everything, is the location freeness of everywhere, is the location freeness of this day, is the location freeness of this moment, is the location freeness of this country, is the location freeness of that ship, is the location freeness of that airplane, is the location freeness of that cloud, is the location freeness of this walkway, is the location freeness of that twig, is the location freeness of this pebble, is the location freeness of this universe, is the location freeness of right now. Right now is totally right now. Now is totally now. Now is totally now. Now is totally now. Truth is totally true. Truth is forever true. Lies are forever lies. No lie can ever be true. Truth is totally true. Truth is totally true forever. Take a rest. Take a rest. Don't evaluate your progress. Catch your wind, just catch your wind. The only problem there is the continuity problem. The vision of oneness is the only value there is. Only the vision of oneness has value. Only the vision of oneness has value. This day, is this ladder, is this bush, is this tree, is this space, is this shirt, is this statue, is this branch, is this trunk, is this wall, is this window, is that telephone pole, is that wire, is that roof, is that cage, is that fence, is that post, is that space, is that car, is that road, is that front yard, is that side yard, is that driveway, is that grove, is that forest, is that river, is that town, is that highway, is that speedometer? Is that glove compartment? Is that seat? Is that branch? Is that leaf? Is that tree? Is that paver? Is that concrete? Is that rock? Is that dirt? Is that universe? Is that planet? Is that river? Is that now? Is that space? Is that truth? Is that truth? Truth is true. Truth is always true. All truth is totally true right now. All truth is totally true right now. Lies are never true. All lies are forever lies. All truth is totally true right now. Try not to gauge the effect. Just let yourself calm down. This tree is now. This tree is totally now. This tree is the total nowness of this branch, which is the total nowness of this bird, which is the total nowness of that mat, which is the total nowness of these stones, which is the total nowness of that dirt, which is the total nowness of that cloud, which is the total nowness of this universe, which is the total nowness of that electrical strip, which is the total nowness of this bark, which is the total nowness of that pebble, which is the total nowness of this day, which is the total nowness of this planet, which is the total nowness of that person, which is the total nowness of that horse, which is the total nowness of that sky, which is the total nowness of this plant, which is the total nowness of that fruit, which is the total nowness of that post, which is the total nowness of this package, which is the total nowness of that table, which is the total nowness of that tape, which is the total nowness of this lid, which is the total nowness of this camera, which is the total nowness of this moment, which is the total nowness of truth. Truth is totally true. Truth is always true. Truth is forever true. Truth is forever true. All truth is forever true right now. All lies are forever lies. No lie can ever be true. All truth is totally true. All truth is forever true right now. Now, I believe there's a cultural inhibition against the vision of oneness because people feel, oh my gosh, if you have the vision of oneness, you're going to exercise us too much practice, too much practice, too much practice. So everyone's afraid, aha, you know, no, no, no. Well, they may not exercise anyone too much, but they may be able to exercise a lot of people just right. See, that's the thing. Yeah. That's what we need, though. That's what we need. It's a kind of thing like it's medicine and we have to take it. This is my point. It's kind of like in California, we have this drought now. You should feel your own life is like a drought. Your whole life has been like a drought, a lifelong drought. You got to break the drought. Or you have to do certain practices to deal with the drought, let's say. We have to deal with the drought. We're taking steps already to cutting our water way back in every way we can think of already. Practices. So we can survive this drought. It's like medicine you have to take. And so that is the attitude you have to have. It's not like, oh, this is an elective. This is an elective. You know, maybe I can take it. It's like a core curriculum. You can't graduate without it. You cannot graduate without it. And so you just say, oh man, you know, this is like any class you're afraid to take. This is going to be really tough. But I have to take it. Got no choice. If I want to graduate, I have to take it. You don't want to flunk, right? You don't want to be a flunky. So you just have to grin and bear it and do it. Now, where there's a culture that insists upon this, like the Tibetan culture, you know, for a long time, you know, a lot of people it's just a given that you're going to be going to spiritual studies and practices, and they practice like, you know, like nonstop from beginning of school. They're doing spiritual practices, they're doing reasoning practices, they're doing all these practices, which is why there's been a lot of realized beings come out of that tradition. And not all of them realize that is true. I mean, they can come up short just like everybody else. That's for sure. It still takes, you know, tremendous practice and stick-to-itiveness for sure. Anybody can get caught up in dogma, get caught up in self-importance. Longchenpa said, it's better to just stay by yourself, stay to yourself, sit in a cave and practice. That's what Longchenpa said. Forget about everything else, all honors, all that stuff, all, you know, position, recognition. Forget about it. Just stick to yourself and practice. You know, the problem is once you get a degree, you might think, I've got it made. I got a degree and now I can teach. And, you know, no, forget about degrees. Forget about your books, writing books, your degrees, all those things. Just practice. inevitably, the ones that succeed are the ones that actually got down to practicing. They finally really, really focused in and practiced. And then the vision of oneness dawned upon them. No question about it. It's there for everybody. The only thing that's blocking us is the continuity issue. And our role is to do this practicing. The Holy Spirit will take care of the vision of oneness. It'll hold it there for us until we're willing to let it dawn upon us. And it'll keep it there for as long, you know, for as long as we need it, for as long as anyone needs it. That is given to us. But our role is to practice changing our expectations of what it is we're perceiving. I'm perceiving the tree that is the fence, that is the roof, that is the hedge, that is the sky, that is the planet, that is the table, that is the stone, that is the mat, that is the driveway, that is the car, that is the cloud, that is the road, that is the window, that is the hose, that is the water, that is the plant, that is the orange, that is the flower, that is the light, that is now. All truth is true now. All lies are never true. All lies are forever lies. All lies are forever lies. All truth is forever true. All truth is forever now. All truth is totally now. Now the personality is going to say, what did you just say? What did you just say? I didn't get it. Can you just do it again? Don't do it again. I don't even remember what I just said. You did it. You did the practice. Now, cool down. You're starting to focus on the next one. You're saying, okay, let it come spontaneously. Yeah, the ego's saying, wait a minute. That sounded like a great practice you just did. What was it again? I kind of missed it. Don't take the hook. Don't bite that hook. This shadow, is this rainbow, is this canyon, is this cliff, is this ocean, is this beach? Is this breeze? Is this day? Is this chime? Is this air? Is this planet? Personality will say, I'm not getting this. I don't quite get it. Personality can never get it. How can nothing get that it is nothing? How can nothing get that it's nothing? How can a mirage get that it's a mirage? How can the rope that we think is a snake, we think, how can that snake get that it's a rope? There is no snake there to get that it's a rope. So how can the personality get anything? Now, don't lapse into nature worship where you say, ah, I'm just in this perfect place here. I just, like, let me just kind of, like, zone out in this nice place. People do it all the time, right? They can do it in their sofa watching television. They think, ah, this is it. No, we're doing active practice. We are preparing for this vision of oneness, which is what we have to practice for. I don't want to try and define it. That's the person I will say, can you just define it for me? Then I won't have to practice. See, that's the trap. Just give me a clear definition, then I'll know what it's like and I won't have to practice. No. Just practice and it'll dawn upon you, then you'll know what it is. So what we're doing is we're beginning to mute the personality demands by practicing. That's what you do. You mute the demands of the personality. This requires a lot of clarity and will to do so, because we're afraid of, oh, you know, I don't want the personality giving me problems. But of course, if it's muted, it's not going to give you many problems. It's when we feed the personality that we get problems. When we try to empower the personality, we have problems. When we try to, all this personality empowerment that the world is obsessed with is a cult, actually. So we want to get out of that cult. We don't want to feed the personality. So we don't explain what the vision of oneness is in terms that the personality can understand. Because again, they will say, well, see, I don't need to practice. I can explain it. I can say, well, personality is the oneness. And see, I got it. Did I get an A in the class now? It's like that. Personality wants to get an A, some sort of diploma. And says, look, I got a diploma in the wall. Here it is. So I don't need to do anything more. See, I succeeded. Now, success is to abide in the vision of oneness. Abidance in the vision of oneness is the success, is the only success there is. Therefore, it's the only value there is. Only that has value. That tree is the value of that sky, is the value of this walkway, is the value of that hat, is the value of that rose, is the value of that pot, is the value of that can, is the value of this planet, is the value of this leaf, is the value of this space, is the value of that bird, is the value of that statue, is the value of that house, is the value of that road, is the value of that fence, is the value of that telephone pole, is the value of this walkway, is the value of that stone, is the value of that little leaf, Is the value of that dirt? Is the value of that pine cone? Is the value of that mat? Is the value of everything? Is the value of now? Now is totally now. Truth is totally true. All lies are forever lies. All truth is forever true right now. So a teacher does not have to give any accreditation to anyone. In fact, they shouldn't, in my opinion. Because once you're abiding in oneness, you know you're abiding in oneness. There's no doubt about it whatsoever. And that is your accreditation. That's the only accreditation there is. And until you're abiding in that oneness, you're not, don't have any accreditation at all. Of course, you can still, you practice, and you can share your practicing with others, of course. You can be like a student teacher, so to speak, but you don't have any real accreditation to say that you are enlightened. You don't. Nobody can give you that accreditation. You will know it when you're abiding in it. There is not the slightest scintilla of doubt that you're abiding in it. This tree is absolutely this stonework, is absolutely this path, is absolutely this wall, is absolutely this garden, is absolutely this park, is absolutely this city, is absolutely this sky, is absolutely this planet, is absolutely this ocean, is absolutely that mountain, is absolutely this flower, is absolutely this plant, is absolutely this spaciousness, is absolutely this one spaciousness, is absolutely this one spaciousness, is absolutely this one spaciousness, is absolutely this bird, is absolutely this water, is absolutely that hedge, is absolutely that gate, is absolutely that roof, is absolutely this bark, is absolutely this place, is absolutely now, is absolutely pure spaciousness, is absolutely pure spaciousness. Now is absolutely now. Truth is absolutely true. Lies are forever lies. Truth is absolutely true. Totally, absolutely true. All truth is totally true now. For me, I feel like a student teacher. I don't make any claims as whatsoever to be a teacher. I'm not a teacher. I'm not abiding in the vision of oneness at this point. That will change at some point, for sure. But now it's like a student teacher, which helps because it's motivate. Urgency. These practices I'm giving out are very good practices. No question about it. Thanks to everyone that's watching. It wouldn't be happening without you, actually, for sure. So the fact that there's receptivity and interest in this, that draws it out. If there's no interest in the world, how could you draw it out? And then it gets really tough, really tough. Keep in mind that those yogis sitting in caves, there are thousands of yogis sitting in caves all over. Everyone they meet is a yogi. So everyone they meet, they feel interest. There's tremendous support and interest. Whereas in this world, a lot of times I feel totally isolated. There's nobody interested. Most of my life I felt I can't find a single person in the world that's interested. So at least here on this YouTube videos, there are people all over the world that are interested, and they're saying, yeah, I'm thank you, I feel this is helping give me some boost, you know. And so the community of interest is important. We don't have to be in the same location, but just the fact that we know that there are those who are interested in this helps everybody out. I feel like I just keep on going. Why stop? It's such an incredible day. It is another summer day in February here. Keep in mind, the world waits for nobody. And there have been many beautiful days in this world where the next day war broke out, okay? War doesn't just break out on a lousy, gray, you know, winter day. Sometimes it breaks out on, you know, beautiful days too, right? Turmoil is no respecter of days here. So we all want to be thoroughly familiar and into our spiritual practice and great spiritual shape before any turmoil breaks out in the world. You might say every day is a super turmoil day in the world, and it is. But the heavy, heavy rain, you know, we want to be sure we are very much in spiritual shape before that happens. And it can very well be our days are very numbered and limited in that regard. Absolutely. Absolutely. Don't put your trust in world events being the way you want them to be. Put your trust in your spiritual practice being the way you want it to be. That's what's key, okay? Put your faith in your spiritual practice being what you want it to be. And make sure it is the way that you want it to be. All right, very great. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching.